Hello everyone, welcome to CMI's Digital Classroom. Today we are going to learn some more practical based question based on the chapter which we are discussing, percentage. For example, I am asking some question. Suppose there is an employee. By mistake, or suppose I have seen good performance of that particular employee and I have increased his salary 20%. So whatever his salary is, I have increased 20%. So here not 20 rupees, I have increased in percentage. Okay. So whatever his salary is, out of that we have find out first the 20% of the salary. That much I have increased. So whatever the new salary is now, suppose due to this COVID pandemic or due to some another reason, now I have decided that no, this increment I cannot give now. So suppose I want to now reduce his salary. Okay, so how much percentage we should reduce to make his salary equal to the previous salary? So this type of questions, it is not like ki 10 rupya badha diye aur phir 10 rupya ghata diye to ye equal ho jayega, because this is all about the percentage. Aapne percentage increase kiya to ek particular number aaya. Jaise maan lijiye agar 100 rupees kisi पर्टिकुलर एम्प्लॉय का सैलरी है और मैंने 20 रुपीस बढ़ाया है, तो 20% ऑफ 100 मींस 20 रुपीस ओनली. सो 120 रुपीस उसका सैलरी हो गया. अब 120 रुपीस से हमें कितना घटाना है ताकि वो जो है उसका इक्वल जो सैलरी पहले था वो हो जाए. तो इस तरह का क्वेश्चन हम इसमें सॉल्व करेंगे. अब मान लीजिए एक क्वेश्चन और है. सपोज the price of petrol is now something, and after few days or after some time or suddenly suppose the price of the petrol is increased. Okay, petrol ka dam badh jata hai, right? So a particular amount is given, that much of amount is increasing. So how much consumptions we should reduce, how much consumptions of the petrol we should reduce so that our budget is in balance. मतलब ये है कि कभी कभी होता ये है कि हम लोग का कुछ भी पर्टिकुलर चीज जो होता है उसका दाम जब ज्यादा होता है या बढ़ जाता है तो हम लोग उसका यूजेस रिड्यूस कर देते हैं, राइट? तो इसी तरह से अगर मान लीजिए नॉर्मली हम लोग कुछ छोटा मोटा काम के लिए भी बाइक लेके चल जाते हैं और अगर पेट्रोल का दाम ज्यादा बढ़ जाता है तो अभी हम लोग सोचते हैं कि नाउ दिस इज हाई प्राइस ऑफ द पेट्रोल इज देयर, सो वी कैन फॉर द स्मॉल डिस्टेंस वी कैन मैनेज विद द पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड ऑल. तो उस समय हमें कितना रिड्यूस करना पड़ेगा सो दैट द बजट विल बी इन बैलेंस, हम लोग को ज्यादा खर्चा पेट्रोल पे ना करना पड़े. ओके, so to solve this type of questions, what process we will use, let's see in this class. So if you talk about question number 12, it is asking Amit was given an increment of 20% in his salary. So whatever the salary is Amit was, that in that first we have given 20% of increment. So if 100 rupees is there, then 120 like that. So if 200 rupees is there, then 20% of 200, so whatever that we have increased. So if his new salary is this much, after increment his new salary is this much. Okay. So that means his old salary plus the increment is equal to this much. So what was his salary before increment? So this you have to find out, this we don't know. So first we have to consider this. Let us consider the old salary is X. Okay, because before increment his increment is 20% and new salary is this one. So first we will consider the total salary. Okay, or old salary let us consider is X. and increment is given 20% and new salary is given is equal to ₹3060. So these are the values which it is given. Okay, now old salary plus increment is equal to this much. Okay, so old salary plus increment. Increment means 20% of the old salary is increased, right? So therefore the equation which it will form is the old salary plus the increment is equal to the new salary, right? So old salary is x plus, यहाँ पे आप लिख सकते हो as per the questions, या according to the questions. Old salary plus increment. Increment is 20% of x is equal to ₹3060. So 20% of x means 20 divided by 100 into x. So here x. So x plus 20 divided by 100 x is equal to ₹3060. So here it will be 100x plus 20x. 100x plus 20x divided by 100 is equal to ₹3060. And view here. So 100x plus 20x, 120x by x. So 100. Okay, so 120x by 100 is equal to this much. So now we want to find the value of x. So x will be 3060. Multiply 100 divided by 120, it will come with side 10 with sense. So 0, 0 cancel, 5, 2 are 10, 6, 2 are 12, 6, 5 are 13, 6, 1 are 6, 0. So x is equal to 510 multiply 5. So x is equal to 5, 0, 0, 5, 1 are 5, 5, 12, 1 are 5. So 2550 rupees. Okay, therefore the old salary is equal to ₹2550. Very simply, पहले आपको old salary consider कर लेना है. Increment हमें पता है 20% है. अगर increment if instead of 20% it is 30, 40, 50 or whatever it is, you can write that much. And a new salary is given. So instead of this value, if any new salary is given, we will write that. And now this is the most important concept to understand, that old salary plus the increment. Old salary plus the increment is equal to the total salary, basically it is given now. So old salary was x rupees plus increment is 20% of x. So 20 by 100 into x is equal to 3060. So if you take the LCM of this, it will 100x plus 20x by 100 is equal to this. Then 120x, 100 plus 20 by 100 is equal to this much. If you take this into that side, so x will be 3060 multiply. This will change, so 100 by 120. After cancel out, you will get 2550 rupees. So this was the old salary. आप इसको वेरीफाई करने के लिए आप जो है इसका 20% चेक करके देख सकते हो, वो जो आपका निकलेगा वो ये निकलेगा, ठीक है? So that will be the verification कि 20% उसका increment करने के बाद ये आ जाएगा, ठीक है? So this is how you can solve this question. Let's see next. Question number 14. It is asking, A's income is 20% less than that of B's income. Whatever B's income is, A's income is 20% less than that. So what percent is B's income more than A's income? So now you have to find the percentage of income which is more than A's income. Whatever the B's income, how much percent is more than that? Less than is given, 20% less than that of B. Amount is not given. So let us consider the amount. So you will take the amount as 100, because 100 का परसेंटेज निकालना हमें इजी होता है. यू कैन टेक इंस्टेड ऑफ 400 टू 300 आल्सो, बट यू हैव टू टेक द परसेंटेज ऑफ दैट, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द परसेंटेज ऑफ दैट. सो लेट अस कंसीडर द बीज सैलरी फर्स्ट, राइट? इज इनकम इज 20% लेस देन बीज इनकम, सो वी विल कंसीडर द बीज इनकम. सो लेट्स बीज इनकम is equal to rupees 100. So 100 rupees is the B's income. So what will be the A's income? So A's income is 20% less than that of B. So therefore A's income will become, income will be whatever is B's income minus 20% of that. So A's income will be rupees 100 minus 20% of 100. So rupees 100 minus 20 divided by 100 multiply 100. 100 and 100 cancel. So rupees 100 minus 20 means rupees 80. So 80 rupees will be the income of A and B's income is 100 rupees. So I am erasing this rough work here and directly I am writing here 80 rupees. So these are the two persons' income given. Now you have to tell by what percent is this income more than A's income. So B ka jo income hai, A ka income se kitna percent zyada hai, right? That you have to tell now. So to find out that, we will consider if A's income is 80 rupees, then B's income is 100 rupees. So if A's income is rupees 80, is rupees 80, then B's income is equal to rupees 100. So A ka jab 80 रुपए का इनकम है तो बी का 100 रुपीज का इनकम. सो इफ आई एम आस्किंग व्हेन एज इनकम इज रुपीज 1, देन बीज इनकम विल बी 100 डिवाइडेड बाय 80, राइट? व्हेन एज इनकम इज रुपीज 100, देन बीज इनकम विल बी 100 डिवाइडेड बाय 80 मल्टीप्लाई 100. 00 cancel, 4 2 are 8, 5 2 are 10, 4 25 are 100. So 25 into 5 is 125. So 125. So here we got the B's income is 125. When A's income is 80 rupees. Right. A's income is 80 rupees, then B's income is 100. Sorry, when A's income is 100, then B's income will be 125. जब 80 था तो 100 हो गया. जब यहाँ पे 100 होगा तो इसका कितना हो जाएगा? 125. ठीक है? हमने 100 इसीलिए लिया क्योंकि हमें परसेंटेज में निकालना है. ठीक है? कितना परसेंटेज इंक्रीज हुआ है? तो sorry. Very simply, अभी हम लोग ये निकाल सकते हैं कि कितना परसेंटेज से इंक्रीमेंट हुआ है, क्योंकि यहाँ पे इसका जब A का इनकम 100 हम लोग ने लिया है तो B का हो गया है 125. ओके, सो नाउ परसेंटेज इंक्रीज इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट यू हैव टू जस्ट सिंपली सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस. ओके, सो लेट अस सब्ट्रैक्ट, आई एम इरेजिंग दिस. So B's income more than A's income is equal to 125 minus 100, that is 25%. So this is how we can say the 25% more is there after this increment. So by what percent is B's income more than A's? So यहाँ पे A से B का जो income है वो 25% ज़्यादा है. अगर if A's income is 20% less than that of B, अगर इसका 20% less है A का income B से, then जो A का B का income होगा वो 25% more होगा. तो यहाँ पे variance आया देखने हैं. यहाँ पे simply if you ask to someone unknown person, they will without calculations they can say directly that 20 and 100 will be the correct answer. But that is not, 20% will not be there, 25% will be the increase more income. Okay. So this type of questions you can solve. Very interesting question. The price of petrol goes up by 10%. Petrol ka dam 10% ghat jata hai. By what percent motorists reduce the consumption? Motorists jo hai kitna reduce karenge? By what percent? Kitna percent reduce karenge of the petrol so that the expenditure on the, on it remains unchanged. So expenditure on it should unchanged. So first you have to consider the cost of the petrol, because cost of the petrol or price of the petrol it is not given. So let us consider, let cost of the petrol is equal to 100 rupees. Now it is goes up 10%. Okay, so 10% increasing, that means cost increased, cost increase is equal to 10% of this, that means 100, it is the earlier price plus 10% increase, so 10% of this, so 10% of rupees 100, so that means rupees 100 plus 10% of 100 means 10 only. So how it is 10 divided by 100 into 100 here only, so 100 will cancel 10, so rupees 110. This is the 110 is the cost increase, increased price, right? So now we will use here the unitary method as like the previous one only, that when in 100 rupees, in 100 rupees motorcycle consumes 1 liter of petrol. So in 110 motorcycle is consuming petrol, so you have to find in rupees 100 how much petrol it is consuming. So it will become 110, 1 divided by 110 multiply 100. So 1010 here cancel, then it will be 10 by 11 liter. So here it will be 10 by 11 liter. So then reduction in consumptions will be 1 minus 10 by 11 liter. So now if you solve this, 11 minus 10 by 11, that means 1 by 11 minus 1, so 11 is 1, 1 by 11, so 1 by 11 liter. So now that means reductions in consumptions you need to do 1 by 11 liter. 1 by 11 liter is to reduce his consumptions. Now this is not the exactly answer, you have to now find the percentage of this. Okay, so now let us find out the percentage of this. So now percentage of reduction, is equal to, percentage of reduction is equal to reduction multiply by 100. So 1 by 11 multiply 100. So 1 by 11 means 100 divided by 11. So this will come as 9.1 by 11%. Very easy. First you have to find the cost. First you have to consider the cost of the petrol is 100 rupees. Then it is increasing 10%, so 110 rupees. Okay, now you have to find that how much you need to reduce his consumptions. Okay, so we got the petrol, the cost of petrol we got, we consider 100, and then we got the increased cost. Now first you have to find out in 110 rupees,
how much he is consuming the petrol. So in 110 rupees he was consuming 1 liter of petrol. So in 100 rupees he will consume 1 by 110 multiply 100 rupees, and after solving we will get that how much of petrol he need to use in 100 rupees. Okay, so that we got is 10 by 11. Okay, and then after that we will find the reduction in consumptions by subtracting 1 from 1 liter. That much he will need to reduce, and after that percentage of reductions is equal to, we can find out. Like, it's very simple if you understand this.
So this is the question which I have discussed at the beginning of the class, that the salary of an officer is increased by 25%, and after that what percent we should decrease from that particular salary to decrease to restore the original salary, I mean, so that his salary will become same. Okay, so here as it is asking percentage, so there is no any in the round number, as like a single number, a simple number, you have to just increase and decrease. So here it is in percentage. Okay, so let us consider the original salary first. Okay, let us consider the original salary is equal to rupees 100. So suppose 100 rupees is the original salary, then increase salary is 25%. Okay, so increase salary is 25%. Okay, so 25% increase means the original salary plus 25% of the original salary. So original salary is rupees 100 plus 25% of 100. So 25% of 100 and 100 means 25% of 100 is 25 only. So 125 rupees is the salary after the increment. Now how much we should reduce from 125 so that his original salary should be 100 only. Okay, this is the most important thing which here we have to find out. Okay, so now salary after increase is 125 rupees. So for original salary reduction, how much we have to do? So for original salary we have to reduce how much? For original salary reductions will be required 125 minus 100, that means rupees 25. So 25 rupees we have to reduce. Now you have to find the percentage 25 rupees of 125. Okay, 125 se hame 25 ghatana hai, but percentage mein ghatana hai. So 25% of 125 you have to find out. Okay, so reduction in percentage is equal to 25 of 125 percent. Percent means 100, we have to multiply 25 5 times are 5 2 times are. So very easily you can see 20% we have to reduce. Okay, so 20% will be the reductions required. Then very simply this will be the answer. 20% reductions we have to do to make the equivalent to the original salary. You can verify this also just by finding the 20% of whatever the amount or whatever the original salary is there. Okay, so this is how you can solve these questions. Okay, question number 25. So these are questions whatever left of this exercise, that is your homework. Okay, so this exercise is exercise 9A. So 9 is all questions is your homework. Few questions are left. So complete that. And with that you can do 9 B's and 6 questions also in the book also only. You can do rough work in copy and choose the correct options in book only. Thank you. Have a good time. Take care and.